You are watching Skyrim commentary from Shauna Films.
See for yourself.
So I've been doing the Warrior Stone.
I knew you shouldn't have been on that cult the minute I
left. I guess the last few playthroughs.
Things are quiet enough here. Come on, there's my uncle.
My continuing quest to become an Imperial Barbarian.
Uncle Halvar, hello. Pat, what are you doing? Are you on leave from...
Sometimes this guy will say something to his mom about the dragon. Sometimes he won't.
Did I see you talking to Sven? Maybe not. Maybe... never mind. But I would stay away from him if I were you.
He's a bard.
And he'll say that comment if he does actually see me standing next to Sven.
Thinks his ballads and sonnets are going to convince Camilla Valerius to marry him. As if she would say yes. An intelligent, beautiful woman.
So
like
since
her
he saw me, I thought, you know what, I'll just do his little thing right now so I can have him as a follower. It's been forever since I used him as a follower.
I've been thinking, maybe Camilla needs a little help seeing Sven for what he
needs. Oh, I remember. I remember royally screwing up this quest, though. Sven?
I think I've matched that Nord's lack of cleverness perfectly. Good day.
Because I'm thinking, oh, easy peasy.
You lost?
Yeah, she's ignoring me.
We're done then? Good.
It all has to do with the Force Greet bubble, which I have turned way down low in my game. So certain things won't trigger unless I'm standing right on top of NPCs.
No adventures, no theatrics, no thief chasing.
Well, what are you going to do then, huh?
And then NPCs can choose to Force Greet me, or just greet me, or just talk to their neighbor when they see that I'm standing next to them. So there I am, all ready to adventure, and
you could talk some sense.
First thing I do is I click on the wrong thing here.
He what? What are you talking about? Why, that jealous idiot. Thought he could just manipulate me into never seeing Sven again? Thank you for telling me the truth. You should speak to Sven.
It's like, sure he'll want to thank abort mission, abort, abort. Try again.
Maybe you could talk some sense into my pig-headed brother. Another poem, I bet. He does know how to make a girl blush. What's this? If that oaf thinks all I'm going to do is stay in that filthy house of his and clean, I'll... You can tell Sven that he already has a mother. I'm not speaking to him anymore. Just leave.
Anyway, she's all upset with me because I'm more attractive. I'm more attractive than she is, apparently. In her mind. Maybe in my mind too, because I set my attraction to 71%, I think it is. On a scale of 1 to 100.
Good to see you. I appreciate your help. Please, take this. Some gold I've saved up from working at the mill.
I don't remember if I left it that way for this playthrough, or if I turned that off, because I was... After a while, you get tired of everyone hating you. I don't want to become an ugly SJW with pink hair just for NPCs to like me. Okay, so now I got Feindahl as a companion. I used him a good amount. Like several levels of him hanging around me. You know, I don't know if you're like me, but I'm like me, and that is, I'll have a companion with me for a few levels until they start to grate on my nerves. It's like, you know what? I'm so done with you. And I find someone new. I find someone else to be my companion until I go cabin fever all over them too. Then that's when I go on the internet and I look for companions to download and try out, which I've been doing in this playthrough. They'll show up, you'll see. They're gonna show up in videos. And they're pretty darn swell, I must say. Even though they all have the same face. That's the problem. These guys and gals that make followers. They're really cool, you know? You see one on Nexus and you're like, oh, that's awesome. I gotta download this. This person looks amazing. And then you go into their user files to see what other companions they've made. And the first thing you notice right away, it's all their female companions have the same exact face. Just slightly different eyebrows, slightly different hairstyle, different makeup. But it's the same mesh for the face. And you're like, okay, so maybe the companion I downloaded won't be as good as the next one. You know, the grass is always greener on the other side kind of thing. So then you have to look at all the companions that person made and you say, okay, which of these is the best of the whole bunch? Then you find out, oh, they've got this Nord person who hangs out at Riften. It's like, oh, okay. That sounds more interesting than the follower that I downloaded initially that is just a Falkreath person who hangs out at the gravesites. Yeah. And since they look exactly the same, it's like, which one should I keep? Which one needs to be kept on my hard drive? You know, that sort of thing. Then you find another companion that's really cool looking and you look on that modder's user files page and you see that, oh, all of their followers look the same too.
Well, that's taken care of. No thanks to you.
That separates the AAA modders from the B-list modders.
Certainly not. But a true warrior would have relished the opportunity.
The B-list modders.
That's why I'm here with my shield.
Their companions all look the same pretty much. The AAA modders. They make an effort to make unique faces and heads for each of their companions that they make. The AAA modders, I'm trying to think of one off the top of my head. Who's the guy that did Saranaholic? If you Google Saranaholic, you'll see maybe 8 versions of her. All of them are pretty much outstanding, and each one has a different head. Each one.
You look strong. Come to your Basker and be a companion.
Some are anime looking. Until some are more Skyrim looking.
Thinking I need to train some more.
But the mod author puts a lot of time and effort into creating unique faces for the NPCs. Another person who's really good at modding new faces and stuff for NPCs is the gal. What's her name? I want to say it starts with an S. I mean, she does what does she do? I'm thinking it's a woman. I want to say it is. I haven't talked to her in a while, though, so I'm guessing she's still a woman. What's her name? But she does Men of War? Is that it? No, it's called Men of Winter. The Men of Winter mod, it replaces basically most of the male NPCs in the game, and they each have a unique face. Not just new hairstyle slapped on their body. But an actual different face.
What? You think you can stand against the entire Whiterun City Guard?
She even redid Nelloth. I mean, who does that? Who redoes Nelloth? She does.
Keeping an eye on you.
Now, some of her NPCs, you look at me like, oh, okay, that's not much of a difference. She just made the guy look younger is all. That's probably true. There's like five or six of the NPCs, and she just made them look younger is all. But who's the guy that does Pandorable? Or maybe it's the girl that does Pandorable. The NPCs, the Dawnguard and the Dragonborn. And I guess the regular NPCs too. They all have the same face. So to me, that's not AAA. That's just B plus. You know, maybe an A for effort. But all the NPCs have the same face. Just give them different makeup, different eyebrow, different hairstyle, and call them a whole different NPC. Make them 100 weight or make them 0 weight, tall or short, you know, that kind of thing. But it's the same head snapped on the body. Different skin color tint.
We are the children of man. Talos is the true god of man.
So my goal in this playthrough is to stay Imperial. Maybe sign up with the Imperials. But we'll see how I'm treated. If I'm treated poorly,
let me know if there's anything else you need.
I'll switch over to Stormcloak in a heartbeat.
What do you want me to carry?
The other goal is to rent the attic room without actually reading the note that Delphine left at Windcaller's tomb. I got the note and I'm not gonna open it, and I'm gonna see if there's any dialogue with her about an attic room. Cause some quests, they assume that you're gonna read the note when you get it, so it advances the quest.
Let me know if there's anything else you need.
Okay, here's an adventure. This is weird. These adventurers that get their bounties, that works one time and then stops. It doesn't work after that again. So I'm thinking one of my bounty quests, one of my bounty mods that I have installed, is breaking immersive world encounters so that adventurers no longer are attracted to stewards to collect bounties. Because the bounties have changed in my game to something else.
Come on then. The Jarl will want to speak to you personally.
So I'll have to let the person who did Men of Winter, she's also done immersive world encounters, I'll have to let her know. That what just happened right now, right there, only happens once in my game, and that's it. It doesn't happen anymore. Since I installed a mod that increases the number of bounties. So the bounties themselves have different forum IDs. Is that the proper verbiage for that?
I learned of a certain stone tablet said to be housed in Bleakfall's Barrow. A dragon stone said to contain a map of dragon burial sites. Go to Bleakfall's Barrow.
Everything was going fine until Feindahl propositioned me at this point. I'm trying to have a conversation with these guys. Really, Feindahl?
I'm sure she will prove most useful. Succeed at this. Be rewarded. White Run will be.
So another thing I want to check in this playthrough is if Kodlak is naked when they're burning him. Cause for some reason he's buck naked while he's being burned.
It's good to see you again.
And I don't remember ever stripping clothes off of his body.
I've got your back. Let's get going.
I think when you click on Kodlak, nothing happens. You're not able to activate his body.
Already on your way to Bleak Falls Barrow. An old tomb built by the ancient Nords, perhaps dating back to the Dragon War itself. Ah, maybe you just want to know how to get there. It's near Riverwood, a miserable little village a few miles south of here. I'm sure.
And then late-term goals in this playthrough is to kill the blades.
Well, must preserve.
I have that mod installed, but I haven't had a chance to use it.
My sources.
Because I haven't gotten that far with the blades
to
get the option to murder all of them.
Neither am I, come to think of it.
And then Parthenax would be my friend. And so will the Greybeards.
Need something? All right, then.
One of the new servants?
And there's a ghost named Helgi. I want to adopt her. In the last couple playthroughs, I didn't get that far in the quest with Marthal. I want to try to do that whole quest line with Alva, without Alva dying. I can never tell where she's at, and sometimes she gets murdered.
Do you have anything you need from me?
During that quest. Sometimes she's walking around town afterwards, acting like she's so innocent. None of it had anything to do, kind of a thing. So we'll see. We shall see if Alva lives or dies in my game.